Pandering to the insecure, specifically on TikTok, has the potential to do tons of damage. To start off, let's make the definition of pander clear for the scope of this video. And that definition is to indulge and provide gratification for others' desires, usually, but not always, in an immoral or distasteful manner. In Bo Burnham's Netflix special, What, he has a song called Repeat Stuff.
Love my baby and you know I couldn't live without her, but now I need to make every girl think this song's about her, just to make sure that they spread it like the plague. So I describe my dream girl as really, really vague, like, I love your hands cause your fingerprints are like no other. I love your eyes and their bluish, brownish, greenish color. I love it when you smile, that you smile wide, and I love how your torso has an arm on either side now.
There are many interpretations of this song, and I believe one of them to be a commentary on how the music industry uses incredibly vague lyricism in pop songs. These vague lyrics are used to target and capture a variety of audiences with a variety of insecurities at a time in order to maximize the amount of profit possible from one song. Having said that, what if I told you that this same theme is being used by TikTok creators? Here are three examples.
Yo, if she's a little thick or overweight and she cries at everything, my brother, wife her up right now.
As you can see, these three examples are very similar in a number of ways. Number one, they all focus on the dominant heterosexual audience with the emphasis on describing a desirable woman for a man. Number two, they all describe generally likable aspects anyone might see in anyone else and things that are widely liked by a large amount of people like pizza, music taste, memes, etc. And number three, they all push this agenda of, if this woman has these features or quirks, you gotta marry her, bro.
Reasons to date her.
Reasons to date her. Gentlemen, listen up.
Number one, she can cook.
Number one, she can cook.
Number two, you can lay in bed naked with her and eat pizza and watch Netflix.
Number two, you can stay in bed naked with her eating pizza.
Number three, she is absolutely hilarious.
Number three, she's hilarious.
Number four, if one and three was not enough for you, just look at her ass.
Number four, if you're not sold on one through three, look at her butt. If that doesn't work, you like men.
If you don't like that, you like men. Get your shit together.
Now, an interesting point here is that anyone who isn't a part of the heterosexual audience can still find a way to shoehorn themselves in relating to these videos because it's the very relatable nature of the topic. Dating, relationships, and love. These creators are using these very widely talked about topics to grab thousands and thousands of likes. Let's talk about this one. If someone really wanted to play the devil's advocate, they could make the argument that this is promoting body positivity because of his if she's a little thick or overweight comment. Sure, but I want to ask you this, dear viewer. Do you want to marry someone or be with someone just because of how they look? Or do you want to be with someone because you love their values, their aspirations, their drive for whatever they're passionate about, the deep conversations you can have after having a meaningless yet fun one, the comfortable silence you both can share because their presence is enough for you to know that the love is there. Need I go on? This comment alone is doing a disservice to both parties, mind you. On one side, the pursuer will believe aspects like these are all that are required to have a good marriage or relationship, but it's not. Meanwhile, on the other side, the target, sorry to put it that way, is thinking they don't need to worry much about personal improvement for someone to find them desirable. All the target needs to worry about are the superficial surface level standards, but it's not. Human beings are more complex than that, and promoting this kind of simplicity is promoting toxic behavior and an unhealthy mindset. Let's take a look at this one. You can argue this person is a bit more niche. They're painting a more specific audience that's heavy on loving K-pop, being a specific body type, and even having a specific name. Here we go. The letter A is the second most frequently used letter in the English language alphabet, and the letter E is the most frequently used letter in the English language alphabet. Also, here's a list of the most popular names for people that were assigned female at birth during the 2000s. Emily, Madison, Emma, Olivia, Hannah, Abigail, Isabella, Samantha, Elizabeth, Angela, Pamela, Sandra, and Rita. You get the point. Moving on Spotify, K-pop averages 7.9 billion worldwide plays per month, which is 27% more from 2021. The average height for people that were assigned female at birth worldwide is 160 centimeters. The brown eyes gene is a dominant gene, and 55 to 79% of people worldwide have brown eyes. TikTok has over 1 billion average users monthly worldwide, with one source saying 33% of them being people ages 10 to 19, which is arguably a very sensitive time for mental and emotional growth, and incidentally, the target demographic. Does that all sound niche to you?
Yo, if she's very sensitive, but has that mean attitude when she wants to, my brother, wife her up right now.
If she has big thighs, laughs loud, snort whenever she laughs, has insecurities, need to be protected, my brother, wife her up right now.
Hey ladies, drop it down. Just wanna see you touch the ground. Don't be shy, girl, go bonanza. Shake your body like a belly dance.
But Marlo, I rarely see those bozos go through my feed. But Marlo, I'm not on that side of TikTok. But Marlo, who's actually going to listen to those guys? Well, dude, just because something doesn't happen to you doesn't mean it isn't happening to someone else. Just because the algorithm of TikTok is gracing you with the lack of these weirdos doesn't mean you should forget how huge their net for grabbing fish is. And finally, let me call back Bo Burnham's commentary with repeat stuff. Let me remind the theme the pop music industry and these TikTok creators are using. They're pandering to a variety of audiences with a variety of insecurities at a time in order to maximize the number of likes from one video. Those who have insecurities, especially with the insecurity of not being pretty or the insecurity of the lack of having a partner or someone to love in general, have a higher chance of taking these messages personally. These content creators are telling insecure people this is all that is required in order to be happy. They're saying, this is all you need to look for in a partner. This is all you need to win a partner. It's easier than you think for someone to fall for you or fall for someone because I, a male with vague attractiveness with an underlying ick and unattractiveness that you know is there but can't quite put your finger on, said so. And look at all these likes and comments that agree with me to prove I'm right. Bigger number, better person, plus L plus ratio. This is all bad, dear viewer. It's false validation from an outside source. Real and more meaningful validation will always come from you first. It'll always come from within. And those with insecurities need a little bit more time and care to learn that. And that's okay. From my experience, there is no set time frame for anyone to become fully aware of who they are and what their worth is. So it's just best to take your time and find resolve within yourself, one small baby step at a time. Again, people are infinitely more complex. These TikTok creators are suggesting that the complexity only goes as far as the surface. The diamonds you seek are far deeper than that, especially after Mojang released the second part to the Caves and Cliffs update. Please focus on yourself and the things that make you happy, the things that improve your own life. Only then will you know how to give back to the people around you, because you've went through it yourself. You know what works, and what works can help other people. It might. And of course, now that you are comfortable with who you are and the things that make you happy, you don't need any reliance on anyone else, it'll be more easier for you to be a better person, a better partner for your significant other. But please, if you notice that this person that you kind of have a thing for is still struggling with their own demons, if they still have things that they're kind of outright insecure about, which is okay to be insecure about things, it's just that, are they helping themselves? Are they trying to find where this source of possibly trauma is? If not, you should tell them to go to therapy. be with them and support them, but they are not emotionally available. Just be with them throughout their journey of improving. Push them towards a certain direction. As long as you're not in the foot race with them, you are rather on the sidelines cheering them on, then that's all you need to do for them. And of course, this is all my opinion. I'm no therapist, I'm no psychiatrist or what have you. I'm just a guy who experienced these things for himself, and I'm at a point in my life where I'm quite happy with where I am. And so this is me trying to return the favor out into the world. And I hope this helps you.
Welcome, friends. I've been expecting you.
Thank you to everyone who has gotten this far. If you like and subscribe, I would very much appreciate it. As I always say, I'm very original. I hope this raised awareness to those of you who come across these kind of TikToks now and then. Don't listen to them. It's superficial. It sucks. It's not the way to go. You can enjoy them as is, as entertainment, as pure entertainment, but please don't take it to heart. Please don't take it personal. It's only entertainment. Let me know what you think about this topic. Of course, this kind of pandering doesn't only exist in TikTok, although it's just very big. It's huge in TikTok. It happens all over the internet. So I would like to know what you think. And other than that, I will see you next time. Thank you.